diet in general seems to be a good predictor of cognitive decline. So this is more data from Rush in Chicago, where they've looked at a special kind of way of categorizing the diet by looking at how closely you adhere to something called the Mediterranean DASH, or Dietary Approach to Systolic Hypertension Diet. And what they find is that people who adhere to this very healthy diet, who have a high score, declining much more slowly over time in their study. So these are people who came into the study in their 60s and 70s, and now they have 10 years of data. And the heavy dotted line at the top there is showing much slower cognitive decline over time than the solid line at the bottom, where the score is low. And it's a little tricky to see, but some of the things that people get high points for on the MIND diet, just a questionnaire, is how many green leafy vegetables you eat, berries, nuts, olive oil, things like whole grains, fish. And then you lose points for things like fast food, pastries, and too much wine, unfortunately. Diet goes along with vascular risk. And we know that vascular health is really important for brain health. What's good for the heart is good for the brain. This is a former research assistant in the lab. Her name is Emeralda Tsitmia. And she did this study looking at the intersection between lifestyle and vascular risk specifically, with something called a Framingham risk score, which combines cholesterol, smoking, diabetes, and blood pressure, with genetic risk, with APOE E4 status. So this is the strongest risk factor for Alzheimer's disease in all of the genetics, at least in white people. And we use the ADNI data here, which is the Alzheimer's Disease Neuroimaging Initiative. And what she found is that women who are depicted in red, who even have a little bit of vascular risk and have that E4 allele, have much higher tau pathology on these three different areas of their brain than do men who are measured in blue. So men have quite a flat line, even though they have that genetic risk. They don't seem to have this intersection with these vascular risk factors. Although we recently did a follow-up study and showed them perhaps BMI, being obese, might be a bigger risk factor for men than it is for women.